obviously we know that you speak German because you're a fucking Nazi.
Mel can't speak German. That's all been. He's like, he just says random shit in German because he remembers it. That doesn't really count.
Flungel, flungel, ja, Hans.
There it is.
See, half of that shit's not even real, Chase. Just saying. Like, yeah, flungel is
yeah, just Hans improvising. Isn't real. Flungel, flungel, those are real, but Hans.
Yeah,
isn't.
Those are real, obviously. Yeah,
that was.
You've been bamboozled.
You've been given the big trick.
I mean, none of you will be surprised. I don't know, you're in Germany, family, you're watch, it's... retard.
Whoa.
What's that? Listen here, you fucking piece of shit.
I love you.
I'm gonna rape you.
No. Whoa! Whoa!
Whoa! We don't
not
do
if I
that
want
anymore.
You
know. Not after yeah. last time.
She's... I can't even say the word.
Facetiously.
Facetiously.
Facetios. None of you will be surprised to know that I know, like, small amounts of Japanese.
Oh, yeah, but no.
Konnichiwa.
No, but we're having the conversation, Metal, you fucking rude boy.
Yeah, Mel, what the fuck?
However,
yeah, but I'm not listening to
you. Spanish is really, like, piss easy to speak in terms of, like, pronunciation for the
Hispanol,
most part, but as a language, it's just sort of like the equivalent of, like, wet bread. Like, it's just everywhere, and it's so commonplace that it's so, it's, you know, you see it on
the
back of every single package.
Like, wet
it's,
bread
you know,
is everywhere?
Yeah.
Yeah, every time I see Spanish, it's right next to English, so I have no desire to learn Spanish.
Yeah, no, seriously, it really is just kind of, I've learned to associate it, I've learned to associate it with, like, blandness, you know?
You go to the bus stop,
I've learned to associate Spanish with lazy people who don't learn English.
Wow. Rags, how have you not picked up on that? He just said wet bread is really common. Like, what does that even mean?
No, I didn't.
I didn't even catch that. I was thinking of something else. Wow, what an interesting thing to say. Wet bread isn't common at all.
Bread is everywhere.
It's like wet bread, it's everywhere.
Did I
what
actually say wet bread is everywhere?
Did you say wet
it's,
bread
you know,
is everywhere?
Yeah.
It's like wet bread, it's everywhere.
That's
wet
what
bread
I, that's
is
what,
used
maybe...
to denote that something is dull, you fucking troglodytes. I know, I know you're intentionally trying to get my goat. I know you're pretending to fucking play dumb to get my goat, and it works
oh
every
God.
Time.
Hey, that's
no,
what I
hilarious.
Do.
If you said it's like wet bread, it's everywhere, that's hilarious.
No. Okay, I understand your the miscommunication now.
No, it's
Spanish.
Your
Spanish is everywhere. Spanish is
like
everywhere.
Spanish is like wet bread. It's
yeah, it's like wet bread.
It's
everywhere.
Like wet bread in the
it's
sense.
It's
okay, do you know what wet bread as a turn of phrase means, Moriarty? You cackling fuck. You chuckle fuck. Do you know what wet bread denotes as a fucking metaphor?
Oh my God. It's everywhere, man. Yeah.
Moriarty, do you know what wet bread denotes as a metaphor? What if you're gonna be fucking laser focused on inconsequential shit, I'm.
Oh, me! It wasn't even
what?
Me with Mahler who caught your stupid statement.
You might have to tell us because I'm looking it up now and I'm having trouble finding a definition.
You having trouble finding wet bread, but it's everywhere, right? What the fuck?
It's everywhere!
Yeah. So the top definition seems
assholes.
To be someone who is weak, frail.
You
call,
instance, wait,
I was under the impression that wet
yeah, this
bread
is, the,
is just something.
Is the,
maybe I meant
this
like
is the
wet,
top definition on Urban Dictionary. Someone who is
I
weak,
get it. I'm wrong.
Frail.
I get it. I'm wrong. Yeah, I get it. I'm wrong.
Are you trying to call
sentence.
The Spanish people weak and frail?
No, I was trying to say it's fucking super milk toast and boring.
Ah,
it's just super.
Okay.
You fucking
okay,
see.
I just checked back on stream. You said wet bread.
You say wet
it's,
bread
you know,
is everywhere.
Yeah.
You totally said it.
No, I never said I didn't say wet bread! What plan are we on? What conversation are we trying to have right now? This is just a game of let Chase talk for 3 seconds, cut him off, insist he's fucking retarded.
Hey, no, because it's funny you said wet bread.
Wet bread
yeah.
And
I like how we've had a whole night of people saying funny shit.
May I revise my statement for the fucking
please
the courtroom here?
Wait, can I ask? I just want to ask Mel one thing. Mel, did you hear him say that like wet bread, that it's everywhere?
Sorry?
Did that happen? Because
okay, there's something called a period, and if I speak quickly, that doesn't mean there's no period. That doesn't mean that suddenly is a comma. That means I talk fast. If I say something is like wet bread, what I mean in hindsight
is that it's weak and frail.
What I mean in hindsight is that it is very, very commonplace and therefore becomes less interesting to me because it doesn't, you know, most foreign languages denote a sense of exotic.
It's a common thing. You don't walk around and there's just wet bread everywhere.
That's because that wasn't what I said. You're still. I've explained like fucking 7 times now that I said Spanish is everywhere.
Wet bread is everywhere.
Yeah.
So
your explanation is, it's like wet bread. You know, it's like it's all over the place. That's your explanation for how you said wet bread.
No, not wet bread. Spanish. Spanish is everywhere. Do you need me to? Spanish, the language from Spain, is everywhere in America. Wet bread is not. Do you have any further questions about this particular bullet point?
I think that you should be, for the sake of appropriateness, not saying wet bread. You should be saying pan mojado.
Yeah, I'm trying. What?
Okay.
Pan mojado.
Okay. Okay. I check back. You asked me a question mutually. It's like, hang on, what's my note? Spanish is like piss easy to speak in like a pronunciation, and it's the equivalent of like wet bread.
The second sentence.
I'm recapping
after
the thing
that
we've said that like 8 times now.
That you said Spanish people are weak and frail, which is fucked up.
Shut up.
We got a lot of Spanish
it's
fans
milk,
on EVAP.
Milk toast.
I want them to know that,
by the
we
way,
value their input.
Milk toast. That kind of is like, you know, when you think about it, that's wet bread. I mean, toast is still bread.
No, so it's not. It's maybe, white bread.
Maybe that's.
Shut I mean, the wet bread. Milk toast would be kind of like wet bread in the sense that milk toast means feeble.
Yeah. I mean, I always took it to mean, from my understanding, I always took it to mean just very uninteresting and bland.
Yeah, I
mean, right?
Insipid. Yeah, bland.
But like, for anybody who's confused,
does anyone have any other questions about
Chase?
That
didn't
whole
mean
thing?
To say that wet bread is found everywhere. Okay, that was a mistake.
Yes.
He did not mean to say.
I'm
that.
Glad we've come to this impasse. We've passed this impasse.
Wet bread was just everywhere.
Like, yeah, I'm not of the belief. And if people would have let me talk for maybe 5 extra
Hold on.
Seconds,
no. I want to take this somewhere else, Chase. How do you think you spell milk toast?
MILQUETOAST.
What do you think it is? Where does milk toast come from? What is the word?
What is the etymology?
I don't know. Why don't you tell me?
No, I'm really curious where, if you had to guess, where would that come from?
It very clearly sounds French.
Well, it's from a cartoon character.
Is it?
Yes. It's a last Caspar. Name of a character.
Yeah, Caspar Milk Toast.
Is it like a really old cartoon?
Oh,
yeah, it's from like the 20s or something like that.
Oh, okay.
It's older, but I don't know when it's from.
Like, where is it from as well?
Where is it? What, I'd have to look it up. Google his name.
Is it like a French cartoon or
Webster?
Also, for clarification, if I said that Rags is like a gun because he's sturdy, reliable, can shoot bullets, and is made of metal, and then someone said Rags isn't made of metal, I'm like, clearly I was referring to the other 3 things. That doesn't work. Like, you can't do that.
Well, that's kind of a ridiculous comparison, but sure. I'll take that.
I felt that was apt, and that's hence my confusion at wet bread being everywhere.
Exactly what his analogy was.
See, there's things that some humans do when they're in a very passionate moment where they just are kind of speaking quickly.
Have you
and so when I say Spanish is like wet bread, period. Full stop, right? Period. Right? Okay. No. I'm just making sure we're all on the same page, right? Are we all understanding
100%, yes.
that's a sentence, right? That has a beginning, an end, and a period, right?
In comes the qualification.
Mahler, wait, no. Mahler, do you agree? Do you agree with this?
Yes,
so
expecting
far?
The qualification.
Are you with me? Metal, do you understand? Are you following me on this?
Are you fucking with me right now?
No, I'm genuinely asking. Do you understand that the phrase, acknowledging right now, right, that the whole wet bread thing was incorrect and I used it wrong, right? I acknowledge that. Do you acknowledge that Spanish is like wet bread, period? That's a sentence, right? Do you acknowledge that?
Fucking course is this? What the fuck are you talking about?
No. I'm just making sure we're on the same page. I'm taking a fucking.
And now,
Moriarty, do you acknowledge that that was a sentence with a beginning and end and a period? I just want to make sure you understand.
One breaking me.
Moriarty, I need an answer. This is very important. You've done this to me. You've dragged this fucking dead meme out for so long. Now I need to fucking make sure.
I just want to point out that he didn't say that was a sentence earlier. He said, when Spanish. He didn't say, he had that when that first time, and now he's changed it to beginning with Spanish. I just want to point that out. My contention was the sentence that began with when.
Or now whenever, when. Right?
Oh, so I see what you're doing. You're continuing to try to annoy me by poking at further and further inconsequential details. You just keep doing it. That's
your
endgame.
I'm going to end my original statement, and I've done that aptly. You may proceed.
Okay. So I said Spanish is like wet bread. Period. And then, so given that the subject of the prior sentence was Spanish,
such
right?
A ridiculous thing.
No, sure. I'm almost done.
Here we go.
Given that the subject from the prior sentence was Spanish, right?
Yes.
It, Spanish, the larger subject we're all discussing, right? Is everywhere, right?
Like wet bread.
But that, okay.
Do we understand this? Yes or no?
Sure.
Do we understand this?
Sure.
Okay, that was all. Just since we seem to have a lot of fucking burning questions about that entire exchange, so I just wanted to make sure we're all on the same page there. That was all. No, I don't have anything further to add.
I never had a question, but not accurately okay.
Referencing you were doing.
Do you see how fucking
However, if I said that Spanish is
I
like
get the
bread,
fucking miscommunication that
everywhere.
You're
you wouldn't assume that I meant Spanish when I said it. You would assume I meant wet bread.
Then ask me.
Wet bread is everywhere.
Yeah.
Wet bread is everywhere, and you go what?
It's like saying,
you know, it's funnier.
It's what? Like saying,
you know, it's a fucking mineable meme.
No, it's like
you go. I'm not gonna check to make sure that that's what you said. I'm gonna assume that you meant the funnier one, and I'm just gonna fucking talk about it.
It is what you said. Regardless of anything,
it
is
what
I said.
But in the context of greater things, I think it's pretty fucking clear that I don't actually think that wet bread is just laying around on the fucking bus or something.
That's why it's so
funny. He's being obtuse.
No.
Chase, come on.
That M stands for fucking mongoloid. That's what
I don't even think you agree with you, Chase. I don't even think you agree with you.
Look, I conceded that the wet bread fucking definition was incorrect.
Let me do a quick example with the gun again.
I'm not infallible.
If I said, again, rags is like guns, and then I went, guns are everywhere.
If you said that sentence on its own as its own separate thing, yeah, that would be an issue. But given that the greater context was us discussing language, Russian, Spanish, Japanese, I think one may infer from that entire exchange, I'm probably still talking about motherfucking Spanish. And bread is not suddenly the most prevalent detail of the entire fucking conversation. I'm pretty sure that's the part I'm more interested in discussing.
Can't isolate one of those things. If I say airplanes are like Oreos, they fly through
the
air.
No wonder people hate you.
It doesn't matter what the broader context is.
Right. Yes. But here's the thing. I know what the answer is here. I know how we can move past this, Chase. I know how we can
leave any
heal.
We can heal. I mean, like, words change. Okay.
Answer. Okay.
Yes.
Words change.
Fuck off. that was good. I'll give you that one.
Between multiple retellings of what the sentence was.
Just ask me next time. I'll easily repeat and clarify.
Wet bread is everywhere?
Yeah.
Wet bread is not everywhere.
That's not what happened, Chase. I started laughing and I was like, wet bread is everywhere? Question mark.
I feel like you're poisoning the well.
Yeah, what's going on here, Chase?
Well. That was my genuine recollection of what happened. This is a shitty fucking Christmas stream, by the way. Fucking negative.
I'm gonna be honest with you, I think people will love this.
I think they will. Maybe. Who said that? That would be hilarious.
That's because I wanted to get back to the subject we were talking about because it was something I actually found interesting. You guys kept what
it's
I was saying was the most incomprehensible
fault.
Thing ever.
Chase, buddy, here's the thing.
Yes.
The day after this podcast goes up, you're gonna be right though. Wet bread will be everywhere.
Oh my god.
Yeah, it's fair. Spanish is extremely fucking commonplace in America. To the point where it's just, you go to a store, you call a hotline. It's like, you know, they're like, oh, well, thanks for calling Wells Fargo for Spanish, press 2. Except they obviously say it in Spanish. So the fact that it's so like overexposed and you fucking hear it and see it like everywhere you go, it kind of removes the sort of like romanticism about it, where you're just like, oh yeah, it's fucking, it's everywhere, whatever. And so like when I was in college, I took French 1 and 2 just because it seems so much more interesting and exotic. And I gotta say, French kind of sucks because every single verb has like an irregular conjugation, so you have to remember the distinct way. The distinct 6 different ways to say any verb in French. Like, most of them are not consistent with their conjugations.
Would you say that French is very facetious?
You know what I would say?
Yeah, I'll be honest with you. I found the web bread conversation more fun than the discussion on Spanish. I'll be honest with you. That's my honest opinion.
Yeah, I guess I just don't care about Spanish, but
not me either.
If a language seems exotic in a way and it's less common, it does tend to be interesting, especially if it does not use typical English letters.
Sure.
Like Cyrillic, alphabet, or characters of, you know, Korean or Chinese or Japanese.
Yeah, like Korean, I think, is interesting too, because I was told by someone that the alphabet is written in a way that like mimics the shape of your tongue that you have to put it in to like pronounce that word or some shit. It seems really abstract for me.
I think Korean, one of the aspects of it is that it was kind of designed to be very easy to learn.
Yes.
So that the regular Tom, Dick, and Harry could learn how to read it and write it. Or I've
Would
heard
you do me a favor, Mahler.
What's like that?
Chinese, other languages.
Would you tell me what the super chat was that brought us here? Because
I was thinking the same thing.
I want to know too.
I was like, what was the last super chat?
The language. Because it wasn't.
I'm
super
just going
chat.
On a stream of consciousness here.
Whoever it was,
it would be amazing.
Look what you did.
Super chat would be like, can we talk about wet bread?
I mean, I wouldn't be surprised if there are bread.
What's the deal with
memes?
Wet bread, guys?
If I see a piece of wet bread on the floor at any point in my life, I'm gonna fucking die.
I gotta say, initially, that like my emotional fucking range for that whole thing went from like amused to just straight up fucking annoyed back to amused. So it's like that was quite a roller coaster.
The human experience.
What a ride! Oh god.
What a ride.
Help.
I think we've all grown a little bit as people since we discussed wet breads.
Yeah, some of us. Yeah.
Wet bread's omnipresence has really forced us all to mature in ways we do. Metal, holy shit, fucking.
Yeah, those surprised me all. I was like,
what did you drink?
I was drinking some water right now, actually. It's 6:30 in the morning.
Is that, maybe the Germans it's water.
Oh yeah, it was the one about being an open Republican on Movie Bob's Martian Colony. That's what got us here.
That's what brought us here?
Obviously. Yeah, I can see the
Obviously.
I think that
Holy
makes sense.
Shit. Thank you, Movie Bob.
That was Zach Gilbert. Congratulations.
If I just show an avatar, and I'm excited how it's coming. It's 2D. It's just in sketch form. Looks really good. Moriarty says, does it change? Which I didn't know what that meant, so I just fucking ignored that useless comment. And then Rags commented, how is that better? ? How is that better?
Inflection is yours.
Yeah, no, I agree. I'm saying that's how it reads.
No, you read it
wrong. Especially given
the...
Given the tone of like I say one thing and then you know people are like well not necessarily I don't know about that. Are you sure that's correct?
Asked you or anyone else are completely earnest.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I mean I know that now. Yeah, okay. But given the trend of the little kind of tit for tat like poking and prodding playfulness, which I understand is not meant to be.
I think given my trend, what I said is supported by my past behavior very well.
Yes. No, I'm just saying when I think if most people, not even just Rags, but if most people were to type, how is that better? ? Like if I'm not even giving it super sassy, how is that better? If it was just, how is that better? You could have been like, what improvements was this like supposed to add? That would have made me been like, oh well, let me tell you.
But couldn't but you
like,
still
how is that better? How is that better? Sort of implies like that it's that it, you do think it's worse than my current avatar, or that it's like on par, like the same.
You think that your current avatar is worse than this one?
Yes.
Yeah. So there we go. There was just what's the issue?
No, the issue. I was just saying like By the way, the reason why Rags isn't responding, because it was like someone said, hi, Rags, and I just heard like, and I just said, oh yeah, he's responding to my thing.
Well, why did you hit enter on that?
I didn't mean,
I was in the,
I'm dumb, I didn't mean to.
Detailing the point, M. Jeez. Yeah, I think what Rags was saying is you chose to interpret it as like really critical on the new avatar rather than complimentary to the old one.
Yeah, that's because that's not how it read to me.
I'm curious why he thought it was better.
Because, I mean, I already outlined that, so it doesn't really... We can move past this. I didn't mean for this to be a whole... I don't want the entire fucking stream to just be Chase defends himself in regards to miscommunications. I think it's really... We could probably discuss way more interesting.
What do you mean by that?
I mean, like... No. You see, you almost got me there. That's pretty good.
Gap. That will not become like wet bread, I promise you.